नष्टप्रायेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तमाश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नन्दनाय च नन्दगोपकुमाराय गोविन्दाय नमो नमो नयनमित्राय वेणुवाद्य विनोदिने राधाधरसुधापानशालिने वनमालिने महाभावस्वरूपास्त्वं कृष्णप्रियवरीयसि प्रेमभक्तिप्रदे देवि श्रीराधिकां नमोऽस्तुते. So we are discussing the conversation between two great personalities or Mahajanas. Prithu Maharaj, being an emperor of this earth, when he performed one sacrifice, so all the great sages, they came to meet him. And amongst them was Chatushkumaras. And when Chatushkumaras, they came, Prithu Maharaj, he glorified them and then he asked a question. He said that we are being materially entangled in so many responsibilities. What we should do to increase our attachment for their Lordship? Because to get connected with the Lord or establish our relationship with him and serve him, that's the real goal of human life. And to achieve that, what one should do, that's the question asked by Prithu Maharaj. And in answer to that question, Sanat Kumar, one among the four Kumaras, he explained the most important thing is for that association of devotees. So who are the devotees? He said, like you only, like Prithu Maharaj, who has a rare attachment for hearing about the Lord. So once you start hearing about the Lord, that cleanses your mind and that cleanses your existence. And once your existence is cleansed or pure, then it becomes easy to connect ourselves with the Lord. In further discussion, he says, दग्धाशयो मुक्त समस्त सत्कुनो नैवात्मनो बहिरंत विचिष्टे परमात्मनो यत् वध्यवाधं पुरस्तात् स्वप्ने यथा पुरुषस्त्विनाशे. Translation and purport by His Loving Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Translation: when a person becomes devoid of all materialistic desire and liberated from all material qualities, he transcends distinction between action executed externally and internally. At that time, the difference between soul and the supersoul, which was existing before self-realization, is annihilated. When a dream is over, there is no longer a distinction between the dream and the dreamer. Purport: as described by Srila Rupa Goswami in Chaitanya Charitamrita, text number, Madhya Lila, text number 169, chapter 19. Anya abhilashita shunya jnana karma adhyana vritam tivrena bhakti yogeni. One must be devoid of all material desires. When a person becomes devoid of all material desires, there is no longer need for speculative knowledge or affirmative activities. In that condition, it is to be understood that one is free from the material body. The example is already given above. A coconut which is dry is loosened from its outward husk. This is the stage of a liberation. As said in Srimad Bhagavatam, second chapter, second canto, chapter 13, text number 6, where it is clearly mentioned, Nirodhasya anushayatmanaha saha shaktivi muktir hitva anyata rupam svarupena vyavasthitaha. Mukti hitva anyata rupam svarupena vyavasthitaha. That means being situated in one's own constitutional position. All material desires are present as long as one is in the bodily concept of life. But when one realizes that he is an eternal servant of Krishna, his desires are no longer material. A devotee acts in this consciousness. In other words, when material desire in connection with the body are finished, one is actually liberated. When one is liberated from the material qualities, he does not do anything for his personal sense gratification. At that time, all activities performed by him are absolute. In the conditioned state, there are two kinds of activities. One acts on behalf of the body, and at the same time, he acts to become liberated. The devotee, when he is completely free from all material desires or all material qualities, transcends the quality of action for the body and soul. Then the bodily concept of life is completely over. Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami Pad says, Ya yasya harerdasya karmana manasagira nikhilashva api avasthasu jivana muktasya uchate. When one is completely fixed in the service of the Lord, he is a liberated person in any condition of life. He is called jivana mukta. Liberated even when within this body, in such a liberated condition, there is no distinction between action for sense gratification and actions for liberation. When one is liberated from the desires of sense gratification, he has no longer to suffer the reactions of lamentation and illusion. Activities performed by the kurmis and jnanis are subject to lamentation and illusion, but a self-realized, liberated person acting only for the Supreme Personality of a Godhead. This is the stage of oneness or merging into existence of the Supreme Personality of a Godhead. This means that the individual soul, while keeping his individuality, no longer has a separate interest. He is fully in the service of the Lord, and he has nothing to do for his personal sense gratification. Therefore, he sees only the Supreme Personality of Godhead and not himself. His personal interest completely perishes. When a person comes out of a dream, the dream vanishes. While dreaming, a person may consider himself a king and see the royal paraphernalia, his soldiers, etc. But when the dream is over, he does not see anything beyond himself. Similarly, a liberated person understands that he is a part and parcel of Supreme Lord. Acting in accordance with the desire of the Supreme Lord. And as such, there is no distinction between himself and the Supreme Lord, although both of them retain their individuality. Nityo Nityanam Chaitana Chaitananam. This is the perfect conception of oneness in relation to the Supreme Soul and Soul. Om Adhyana Dimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Malitam Yatasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manokrishnam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupas Amayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham
श्री गुरु श्रीयुतात्मकम् श्रीगुरूण वैष्णवांश श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगण रघुनाथन्वितं तं सचिवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगण वनिता श्रीविशाखान्वितं नमः ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिने नमः नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शुद्धवादिने पाश्चात्यदेशतादि पांचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरद्विषे नमः पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं आनन्दलीलामय विग्रहाय हेमाङ्गदिव्याचले सुन्दराय तस्मै महाप्रेमरसप्रदाय श्री चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो नमस्ते। आराध्य भगवान व्रजेश तनयस तद्धाम वृंदावनम श्रीमद आराध्य भगवान व्रजेश तनय तद्धाम वृंदावनम रम्या काच उपासना व्रजवधु परिमेन कल्पिता श्रीमद भागवतम प्रमाणमलम हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीन बंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरे वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिय दग्धाशयो मुक्त समस्त गुणो नैवात्मनो बहिरंत विशेषः परमात्मनो यो वध्यवधानं परस्तात् स्वप्ने यथा पुरुषत् विनाशः। When a person becomes devoid of all material desires and liberated from the material qualities, he transcends distinction between actions executed externally and internally. At that time, the difference between the soul and supersoul, which was existing before self-realization, is annihilated. When a dream is over, there is no longer a distinction between dream and the dreamer. So here clearly explained about the situation or characteristics and qualities of a person who has attained liberation. Most of the time we see that some people, they practice spirituality. A little bit of advancement, other people, they try to judge them or they try to explain about that person that, oh, he's a self-realized. But what makes him self-realized? Because sometimes the self-realized person also can be seen performing the same activities that we are performing. Then how to make it out that person is self-realized? So that has explained here. Sanat Kumar says that person, when he becomes totally devoid of material desires, he may be performing some activities which seems to be like a common man, but he does not perform that because he wanted to get some material desire fulfilled. Like building this temple. People, when they construct something, they have some desire behind that. There is some purpose behind it. Either you chant or hear. You do one thing at a time. Not having bid-bag and listening lecture. That's not good. People have many more desires actually. Or they have their own purposes behind the doing few things. But most important thing is that that desire really meant to puff up his ego, or he's desiring that thing even though it seems to be material, but he's doing for the satisfaction of the Lord. When we construct building, it has a purpose that we wanted to achieve something, maybe for the office, maybe for the house, maybe for making a godown, or maybe for the business. But once self-realized person, he builds a building, he has a reason behind that. He wanted to satisfy the Lord by doing that. He wanted to use that thing for the service of the Lord. Like we had also our BBT godowns, and other people, they also have their godowns. But having those or possessing those or building those has a totally different purpose. One is meant for making money, the other is meant for the propagation of the message of their Lordship. One person, he asked Prabhupada, are you self-realized? Because nowadays people, this word, they take it very cheaply, like meditation. No? The thing that I'm going for meditation classes. Meditation is the sixth stage of Ashtanga Yoga. Without following yam, niyam, asana, pranayam, pratyahar, they directly go for dhyana, the meditation. And they consider themselves as a yogi, you know. And they title themselves as a yogi this, yogini that. It's just nonsense. You can't just build a sixth floor, can you, without building a foundation? Can you consider that person as the most intelligent, that he has created a direct sixth floor of the building before constructing the foundation? Is that possible? But people, they do nowadays, you know. They think themselves more intelligent, and they think that they can attend direct the sixth stage of yoga, meditation. Because they are devaluing the worth of words. Words has their own power, you know. So when you say self-realized person, that means he should be devoid of any material desire. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur says, you may have attended the highest stage of a bhakti, but if you get small desire to eat a gulab jamun, that will become a big wall between you and God. That's why some Mayavadi, they said, we need to become desireless, you know. You can't become desireless. Is it possible? Can he stop the waves of ocean? Is that possible? No. In same way, you can't stop desiring. That's why it is said that you should dovetal. Okay, you have to desire, then desire for the service of the Lord. Then that desire will not bound you in this world. It is clearly said that when a self-realized person, he performs the activities, then the distinction between his internal and external activities, it vanishes. It gets annihilated. Why? Because he does not have any hidden agendas. We may come to the temple. We may want to do some service, but we may have some hidden agenda behind that. Rather than serving the Lord, there is something else that you want to convey. When that is there, then your service or your state of consciousness is never considered spiritual. It is contaminated. But when devotee, his hidden agenda and what he shows both became seen, then there is no distinction between that. Kamam tu dasya natu kama kamya. As explained in the qualities of Ambarish Maharaj, that his desires became the desire of their Lordship. That's the real perfection of a devotee. When his desires, they become same as the desire of the Lord. And what is Lord's desire? What he wants from us? Does he wants to get your dhana? Does he ask that? Dhanam dehi? No. We ask, we go to the Lord and we pray for that. Give me my bread. We show that we don't have faith in him. Do you go and ask your father every day? Do you do that? You get up in the morning and say, Dad, are you going to give me a food today? Do you do that? No. You know that my father is going to give me. I don't have to ask him for that. But we don't have a faith. That's why we go and we ask for that. And Lord never asks that things from you, does he? Because he is the one who fulfills everyone's desire. Eko bahunam yo vidadhati kama. He is the one who has a capacity to fulfill each and every individual's desire. Sometimes I myself don't know what are the desires are there in my heart. But Lord, being our intimate friend, which is known as a Surat, he sit next, right next to us in our heart. He is present in each and every individual's heart. So he knows what's going on in your heart. And when, as explained in the previous verses, that when the person realizes the existence of God in his heart and establishes his relationship with the Lord, then there is no difference between him and the Lord. Because knowing Lord in everyone's heart, he desires the same as Lord desires. And Lord desires that all we should go back to him. As we have gone away from him, we are suffering. That's the cause of our sorrow, pitiful condition in this world, that we are away from the Lord. Leaving him aside, we are trying to find happiness. Is it possible? What do you think? What gives you happiness? The things that you buy or things that you see? What really gives you happiness? Sorry? Family brings you happiness. Okay. So family is the cause of happiness? What really gives us happiness? It's you. If you feel happy, then only that thing will give you happiness. Sometimes family members, they go against our will, our desire. They become obstacle in our sense gratification. Do they become the cause of happiness? No. So what gives you happiness? It's you only. If you think that it gives me happiness, it will give you happiness. Like when you are 3 years old, one of your uncle or aunt, she comes with the tricycle and she gives you as a gift. What happens then? You ride on that, you go to the neighborhood, you show your hands, you show your happiness. And same tricycle, which is the cause of your happiness, if that is given on your 18th birthday, will that be the cause of happiness for you? Because same thing, which was given in when you were 3 years old and now you're 18 years old. You will say, what a crazy nut is this. This is what I should ride now. They should give me a four-wheeler because I can have license, I can move around. Same thing, then where the happiness lies? It lies with you or with the articles, things, objects, relations, where it lies? It's with you. And when that happiness you realize, when you connect yourself with the source of that happiness. And who is that source of happiness? Krishna. Krishna, who resides as a super soul in everyone's heart. So when soul, he connects himself with the super soul, then he realizes the real existence. And that is Anandamaya Abhyasa. Every moment he is in bliss, not in happiness, but he is in bliss. Happiness has a opposite word, sorrow. but bliss does not have anything. Ananda, that's what we call it. And that's the real symptom by which you can make it out whether he is a self-realized person or not. The person who is always in bliss. Sometimes if you keep smiling also, people, they have doubt in their hearts. Why you smile always? Why is always smiling? That gives the suffering for them, you know. Because they don't have that experience of always smiling. Why person smile? Because he's happy. A sorrow person or person who is totally sad, he can't give a smile, can he? No. But people in general, they don't have that experience of real bliss, which you can get by serving their Lordship. And that's the real thing. The first thing of self-realized person is that, because he does not have a difference between his external activities and his internal activities. Like an elephant's teeth, you know. He has teeth to chew and to show. Generally what we see, elephant's teeth, that is tusk, and the other teeth that he eats, they are totally different. But a spiritual personality or self-realized personality, there is no distinction between his internal activities and external activities. Whatever he is inside, that's he is outside. That's the main thing. Unless and until we never annihilate this distinction, we can't say ourselves as a spiritual person. We pray every time in Narasimha prayers. What we say? Ito Narasimha, Parato Narasimha. Yato Yato Yami, Tato Narasimha. Bahir Narasimha, Ridaya Narasimha. That means, what it means? Wherever I go, Lord Narasimha is there. Ito, either here, there, inside my heart, outside my heart, he is there. If we really realize this, can we pretend? Is it possible for us to pretend? No. Because we know there is one person who is always watching at me, and he knows who am I. So whom should I pretend to be? But still we do. Why? Because still we are on the bodily concept of life. And that's why in the Bhagavad Gita, the first teaching that Lord has given to Arjuna, that he says, come out of this bodily platform. You are not this body, but spirit soul. That's your real identity. And once you are established in that identity, then it's possible to really experience the bliss, the real bliss, which is called as a ananda. We get excited because we are on the bodily platform. But once, as explained in the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, yasmin sthitopi dukkhena gurunam apina vichalyate. Once the self-realized person is situated in that particular position, then even the biggest turmoil comes in his life, he never gets disturbed by that. Why? Yasmin sthitena, because he has established himself in that platform. And which one is that? As explained in the purport, Prabhupada says, ya yasya, he quotes from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which Rupa Goswami says, ya yasya harer dasya karmana manasa gira nikhilapi avasthasu jivan muktasya. The person, when he dedicates everything, whichever he is doing, by karma, by activities, manasa, by mind, and vacha, through his vani, whatever he does, when he engages that for the service of Krishna, then nikhilapi avasthasu, in all situations of his life, he is jivana mukta, he is liberated within this body. And that's the glory of devotional service. If you take other process like a jnana or knowledge by karma, performing activities, or yoga by performing ashtanga yoga,
you will get desired result or you get liberation at the end of life or sometimes maybe in the next life. But if you do devotional service, you render devotional service to the Lordship, that gives you liberation right at that moment and within this body itself. Jivan Muktasya Shate. Yayasya Harildasya. But that is the service to the Lordship. So when you render service to the Lordship, when you established your relationship with the Lord and act accordingly, then you are Jivan Mukta. Hare Krishna. So we'll stop here. Shri Satyanand Kumar ki, Jai Bhutu Maharaj ki, Jai Srila Prabhupada ki, Jai.